Castillo Morning Show. Of course, Candy, super producer Big Earn, Rasad, Mad Dog on the one and twos, and it's about that time, man. We got my man Michael Jefferson with Truth to Power. How you doing, brother?
Good morning, Juan. Good morning, morning team.
Good morning, Mike.
Yeah, Juan. So first, let me start off by saying happy birthday to Dr. King. Today is his actual birthday.
That's right.
The dreamer would have been 90 years old.
Wow.
Today, but I want to discuss this recent interview of the Republican Congressman Stephen King from Iowa's 4th District, which includes Sioux City, just to give you some perspective. He was just narrowly reelected to his 9th term, which speaks volumes about his constituency. But this man is an enthusiastic supporter of far-right groups and figures in Europe, folks I like to compare to Nazis, and apparently a proud white supremacist. This is what he said recently in a New York Times interview, and I quote, "White nationalists, white supremacists, Western civilization, how did that language become offensive?" Unquote. That's like saying, when did promoting slavery become so offensive? Well, when did the Confederate flag become so offensive? When did praising Hitler become so offensive? That's the perspective here that we're dealing with. So the chair of the Congressional Black Caucus, Karen Bass, she's a Democrat out of California, said in a statement, I quote her, she says, like Donald Trump, Stephen King has sought again and again to give comfort to white supremacists, something that should never be allowed in the halls of Congress or the Oval Office. And of course, the CBC moved to have him stripped of his committee assignments, and that's exactly what happened yesterday. House Minority Leader Kevin McCarthy, a Republican, announced yesterday that King was in fact stripped of his committee assignments, meaning he will not be sitting on any committee in the 116th Congress. And you know, the committees run Congress. But he was a member of the Judiciary Committee, a powerful committee, the Agricultural Committee, and Small Business Committees. So he will not have a committee assignment. He will not have the power to help make laws or laws coming out of those committees. Other Republicans have also denounced King.
That's right.
The Majority Leader, Mitch McConnell, denounced him. You know, there was a time, Juan, when folks like Stephen King were, men like him were considered the norm, you understand? But those days are long gone, and he needs to get a grip and understand just that. And black people, I think, must make it our business to never tolerate any kind of racism in our midst. Mm-hmm. Our number one priority, and I say it today and I've said it before, must be to create safe havens where our children can maximize their potential as human beings. And that means we have to do everything humanly possible not to allow racism to impact us in our communities, in institutions that govern us, and this society at large. And I mean, whatever it takes, we have to be ready to fight racism. And that doesn't mean we don't take our eye off the ball, because we still have to eradicate self-hatred. That's something we have to do. And hopefully, you know, and this is a long shot, but whites really have to step up to the plate and begin to challenge racism within themselves, within their families, within their social circles, and within their own communities, because they can make the difference.
And I'm encouraged by this situation, because I was very, when McConnell came out, I was like, whoa, what?
Oh, yeah.
You know, I mean, and so I was encouraged by that. But then the other thing is that you talk about when you put someone in power and they get on these committees, how important that is, right?
Right.
So imagine with that kind of attitude on the Judicial Committee.
Right.
That's deep, brother.
Right. And you know what? What's interesting about it is that there are a whole lot of folks who feel like him. They're just not, they're smart enough not to open their mouths.
Right.
You know what I mean? So, but he was, you know, I mean, there are folks who think like this all across this country. We have folks, you know, wherever you look, they're there. He was just openly racist about, you know, in terms of his views. I mean, in terms of how he felt. And he felt, you know, there was an arrogance about him that, you know, made him think he could say it. at any time, at any place, and he did, you know. And this is a guy, I mean, when I'm telling you, he took trips to Austria to meet with the far right. I mean, we're all over Europe. He's stomping around and coddling these individuals. And it's a danger. It's dangerous to us. It's dangerous to this society.
Absolutely. Brother, thank you so much, man.
You're very welcome.
Bringing us information that we need to know. Absolutely. Truth to power. Michael Jefferson, keep it right here where you got it.